Hi friends, welcome to Tutors Funny channel. Today I am going to teach how to make the simple CRUD system using JSP. Let us show the demo first. Here, first I am going to add the student name. I am going to add the student name as Peter. Course, I am going to enter as Java. Fee, I am going to enter as 20,000. Right. Click submit. Record added. Now you'll be able to see the record on the table here. Student name, course Java, fee, and fee. All the details will be added into the table successfully. Now, if you want to edit the record, click on the edit button. If you want to delete the record, click on the delete link. Right now, I'm going to edit the record. So, click edit record this one. Right. If you click edit button, it goes to the simple form look like this. Here you will be able to edit the record. Right now, if you want to make the changes of the course fee, I'm going to change as 15,000 and click submit. Record updated. Click OK. After that, click back. Now you will be able to see the record right here. It updated successfully. Right now, if you want to update this record, click on edit. Now if you want to change this one as a instead of JSP, I'm going to change this one as a PHP. Right, submit, record updated, click back, you'll be able to see PHP. Right, perfect. Right now, if you wish to delete the record, click on the delete link. Right here, this one, click on delete, record deleted. Right now, if you go back, now if you refresh it, now here there is no record available. Right, this is the simple system how to make step by step. I will teach now. Right now, let's back to our tutorial. I have used NetBeans to do the project. Right, NetBeans I did to do the project. So what I'm going to do is here, first step, I'm go to the file, new project, select the Java web folder, select the web application, click next. Here you have to type the project name. So I'm going to type the project name as stud. Right, this is the project name, student. Right, click next, click next, finish. Right, now your project has been successfully created. Here, stud. This one should be your project name. Your project folder consists of the folder. These are the folders consist: web pages, source packages, library, and configuration files. So first, I go to the web pages. Click on the plus sign. Here, defaultly one page is created: index.html. This one we don't need it. So we have to this one. We have to write. This one we no needed, right? The index.html, select this one and right click, delete. Are you sure want to delete the index.html? Yes, right. Now, again, after delete that, select the web pages folder again, right click, new, select the page as JSP this time, JSP, right, select this one. Now it's asking the page name. You have to give the page name as index only, right? Don't type .jsp here. It's automatically selected as JSP type, right? You just type as index. Click finish. Right. Now your page has been created successfully. Index.jsp. It's created successfully, right? Now what I'm going to do is here. I'm going to design the page first, right? Now here this one has very no needed. We have to remove them. After that, what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to add the Bootstrap plugins. So here, go to the Google and go to the Bootstrap site, type Bootstrap. So this is the site, click on this one. Here, click download. Here you will be able to download the CSS and JSS. Click download. Here it's download, right? Now here its download has been completed here. Now what I'm going to do is here, right click, show folder. This is the download folder. Copy this file and put into my F drive. Here, right click and extract all and extract it. Right. Now it's coming as a normal folder. This one right click and I'm going to rename it as a, this one as a bootstrap. Perfectly. Now if you open the folder, you will be able to see the CSS file and JSS file. Now here what I'm going to do is here, this folder copy and paste into your project directory. This is your project directory. Folder name. Here this is the web pages. Select the web pages, right click and paste it. Right. Now your bootstrap is successfully added into the project. Right. Now what I'm going to do is here. Now I'm going to add the bootstrap CSS into your project. So expand the bootstrap folder. Now here there will be the CSS file. So here first what I'm going to do is here, inside the add tag, I'm going to link them. So select the bootstrap.css, drag and drop inside the head tag. After that, again go to the bootstrap, inside the bootstrap folder, bootstrap min.css, select and drag inside the head tag. Right. You have to successfully, you have to link them. These two files are needed. Right. After link the bootstrap files, I'm going to style the form. So this one should be the heading. So I'm going to, here I'm instead of the hello world, I'm going to write as a student registration system cred using JSP. Right, I just like write like this. Now what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to design the form. After that, first I'm going to write a div. First div class row after that what I'm going to do is here, inside the div I'm going to write the another div class. This one should be, I'm going to write a skull sm4. Right, after that I'm going to create another div inside the here, control C to copy, control V to paste below. This one should be 8. Right. Okay. Right. This one for form creation, this one for table creation. Okay. This one for form creation. This one for form creation, this one for table creation. Right. Now here what I'm going to do is here I'm going to create the form. So first I'm going to create write a tag form tag form class theater card class method post. Right, action, what that action you have to write as a asterisk. Right, that's it. Right, open the form tag, you must close the form tag. Right. Now here inside the form tag we have to design the form. Right, this one here I'm going to first write as a another div. Inside the form I'm going to write the div align equal left. Right, perfect. Start the div and we have to close the div. Right, perfect. Now here what I'm going to do is here, right, here I'm going to design the label first. Label class form label. Right, start the label, we have to close the label. Right, here I'm going to write as a student name. first one should be the student name, right? After that, we have to create another thing, is a input box, input type. Here we have to write as a type text. This one should be text. After that, you have to write class, form, controller, right? Here, placeholder, student name, after that name equal to this here also is name, after that ID is name, the same thing. After that, here this field should be required. That's the thing we have to do, right? You have to remove it. That's the thing we have to write, right? Perfect, right? This is how we have to create the student field. After that, the same things do. Control C to copy, Control V to paste below, right? This time I am going to change this one as a course. If you write once, you have to reuse it, okay? If you write from the beginning, look like this, it takes too much of time to complete the project, right? This is the way you have to do the project, okay? Second one should be course. This one should be, you have to make it as course. This here also, this one should be placeholder also, we have to change it as a course. This one should be, name should be course. This one should be course. Right, perfect. After that, third one also, Control C to copy, Control V to paste here. This one we have to change it as a fee, right? Fee here also, placeholder also fee, name also fee, ID also fee, right? That's the thing you have to do, right? After that, we have to design the button. So Control C to copy this div, Control V to paste below. This one should be button, should be alignment right. Right, here we no need the index, input box and label. Instead of that, we have to write as a button. So we have to write the bootstrap one, button type button. Here we have to write a type as like this, input type submit, ID submit, value submit, right? Perfect. After that, you have to name also, you have to press submit. After that, class, your style, the bootstrap btn info. That's the thing you have to write. Perfect. After that, what I'm going to do is here, the same thing I'm going to copy, Control C to copy, Control V to paste below. This one should be reset. This type should be reset. Input type, Control C to copy, Control V to paste here. Here also reset, Control V to paste here. Here also reset, paste here. Here change the style as warning, right? That's the thing, right? Now let's check how the form look like. Select the index.jsp page, right click, run file. Here your page look like this. Why is the border is coming around the form? Let's back to our project. Here the form, I have given the class style card, that's why we have to remove the style card. That's the thing we have to do. Now let's run again. Select the JSP retext or JSP run file. Now here it's not coming that broader. Now here we need a spaces between this text and button, right? So how to make that one is here, in between fee and button. So here we need to add the break tag. That's only. That's the thing we have to do. The same thing here also as well. Adding an form, we need a simple break statement. Now let's run and check. Now it's everything working perfect. Now I am going to design the table only here, right? I am going to design the table. So what I am going to do is here, go back to our project. Here table creation we have to create here, div class called sm8, right, inside here. So here what I am going to do is here, I am going to create the table. So first I am going to write as a class, div class. Here we write the panel body. This one should be a panel body. Here inside here we have to write a table. So we have to write a table here as table ID. Here it has TBL. Here we have to TBL student. Here class we have to write table, table responsive, right? Table responsive. After that table border, right? This is a class, right? After the cell padding equal 0 0, and width we have to give the width as 100%. This is how we have to make the table, right? Press enter key. Now here we have to open tag of the table. You have to make sure close tag, right? In between the tag we have to write the, first you have to write thread, right? After that we have to write the tr tag, open tr, and we have to close tr tag, right? Here first you have to write the adding. So th, first one should be this one. These are the headings of the curve. First one should be student name. After that Ctrl C to copy, Ctrl V to paste below. This one should be course. Third one should be Ctrl C to copy, Ctrl V to paste, Ctrl V to paste. This one should be free, right? After that what I am going to do is here, select this one, Ctrl C to copy, Ctrl V to paste here. This one should be edit. This one Ctrl C to copy, Ctrl V to paste. This one should be delete, right? These are the things we have to do. These are the headings. After that we have to write the tr tag. Here we have to display the data. So tr close. Here we have to write the tds, td close it, right? Sorry, not tr, td. Here Ctrl C to copy, Ctrl V to paste. We need 5 tds, 4 5, right? Here how many columns available? 5. Here you have to put 5 tds, right? Perfect. Now let's run the program and check. Select the index.jsp, right click, run file, and the output is coming like this. Here the table should be display at the right side of here, right? Now it's coming below. What is the problem? Let's back to our design. The problem is this, I think. The div is starting here. Yeah, I didn't write the closing tag. Right here, this one should be the closing tag. Right. I didn't put the closing tag. That's the problem. Right. Perfect. Now let's check whether it's working fine or not. That's a problem, I hope. Right, it's working perfectly. Here, it's working now perfectly. Right, the only the problem is I didn't close the div. That's the problem here. right? I didn't close the div tag. After that, I'm going to write the insert code, right? Now here, if I run the project, if you fill the form here, John, student name, course Java, fee 12,000, click submit, record should be added into the database table, right? That's the thing I'm going to teach now. Let's back to our project, go above, right? Here I'm going to write the JSP tag, right? Now here I'm going to write the JSP tag for that, right? First I'm going to write JSP tag expression. We have to write this one, starting tag, you must close the tag, right? When you start the tag, you must close the tag. After that, you have to write at, same thing, at page, you have to write at page, import, you have to import the SQL packages. So how to import the SQL packages in Java? You have to write java.sql dot asterisk, right? Dot asterisk, that's the thing you have to do here, right? Now we have to, right, that's the thing we have to do, asterisk, right? So all the SQL class will be, if you put the this one asterisk, all the SQL class will be include here, right? After that, we have to write the things. Let's JSP. First, you have to write a JSP starting tag. And closing tag. Inside the tag, we have to write if request dot request dot get parameter. So we have to write submit. Submit means when you fill the form and click the submit button, it goes to the this form, same form. It's got, so that we have to write if request parameter submit, right? Submit. Here we have to write not equal null. You write not equal null, not equal equal not equal null. But it's not null, the value is not null, right? First, what I'm going to do is you have to create the variable, and as I create the variables, so request dot get parameter, right? What are the parameters coming here? We have to write first, what should be this one, this field, this name, this one, control C to copy, control V to paste here. Same thing here, control C to copy, control V to paste below, right? Now here, what I'm going to do, the second one should be, first should be name, student name, first field should be student name, second one should be course, third one should be field, course, this one should be field. This one should be course, this one should be fee. Alright, that's it. That's the thing we have to do. After that, we have to make the connection object. Connection. Right. Connection object, connection.con. Right. After that, what I'm going to do is, after that, you have to write a prepare statement. PST, right. After that, we have to write result set. RS, right. Perfect. Now, what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to create the database of the MySQL server. So, let's back to our go here and type localhost. I have installed the XAMPP server in my machine. If you don't know how to install the XAMPP server, just go to the Google and you have to search XAMPP download here, right? You have to download and install this one, right? MySQL database you have to install, right? I already installed, no need to download them, right? I installed, right? After install, you have to go to the browser and type localhost, you will be able to get this nice dashboard, MySQL Server dashboard look like this. Here, if you want to make the database, you just click on this one, phpMyAdmin. If you click, it goes to the relevant part, right? This is the dashboard of MySQL. Right now here, what I'm going to do is here, yeah, I'm going to create the database. So let's click new. I'm going to create the new database. First, I'm going to give the database name as and just give the database name as student school, right? School, I just put two, right? School, right? Click create. Now my database has been created successfully. Now here I'm going to create the table inside the database. I'm going to create the table name as records, right? How many records we have? How many columns? Only three columns: student name, course and fee. So here I need four columns because I need the ID as well, right? So four columns, click go, right? ID should be auto increment. So ID length 11. Here you have to index, you have to select as primary. Here you have to auto increment, you have to do like this, right? After that, second one should be student name, st name. Student name I have shortly, I have written st name. Select the data type varchar, length 255 characters. After that, course varchar 55 characters, fee, this one should be int, right? That's the thing we have to do. Let's click save. Right, your table has been saved successfully, right? Your database created as a school. Inside the database you have a table name records, right? It's created successfully. Now let's back to your project, right? Now here go to the divide this, right? This one should be which one, right? It's not this, right? Here this is my project. Now here let's write the code here, right? Here we have to write the code as first we have to import the MySQL driver. For that, in order to connect MySQL server and our Java, right? So here we have to add the MySQL library. So let's go to the, again we have to go to the Google, we have to download the MySQL library. So here you have to write as MySQL connector for Java. You just search from Google, MySQL connector for Java. This is the link. Click on this link. Go to the site, this site. Right here, come down. At the end, you can see platform independent zip. Right, MySQL connector Java. This one, this zip, you have to download. Right, how to download this? Click download button on the right side. It goes to the download here. You don't need to log in or sign up, you just click on this link, no thanks, just start my download. If you click this one, your download has been started, right? You can see the taskbar here, right? Your download has been started here. It started. I no need to download, I already download, so let's cancel it, right? After download, your zip, it is folder should be become a zip folder. So I show the zip folder like this. It look like the zip folder look like this. You have to extract them. Click on this one, right click, and select the extract all. If you extract all, it is if it is extract, it's become a normal folder after extracted, right? You can see that it's extracted, it's normal folder look like this. You have to see, this is the jar file we have to relate it, right? This is the jars, right? So what I'm going to do is here, go to the project, select the library, right click, add jar folder. Here go to the MySQL connector Java. Inside you have to these two bin folders, this jar file we have to add that into the library. So select them, these both, click open, right? Its jar should be added into the library successfully. Here you will be able to see, right? Now what I'm going to do is here, after that we have to go to here, we have to write the code here, right? Con equal connection equal driver manager dot get connection. Here we have to write JDBC, MySQL, localhost. Here we have to write what is the database you have created. You have to give here what is the database name. Is cool, write this one. So I have to write properly. Is cool. I have write additional L also. Is cool, right? This is the one. After that, what I'm going to say, comma. When you install the exam server in your machine, default username will be root, default password will be blank, right? You have to put here. Default username will be root, default password will be blank, right? That's the thing we have to write here. After the connection, this is the connection where the your database located in the localhost, right? This is the database name, this is the right. After that, what I'm going to see, I'm going to write a prepare statement. I already created the object prepare statement. You have to write here. Here we need to write another stuff. So we forgot it. We need a driver, MySQL driver class. You have to class dot for name. Here we have to write this one as a com dot MySQL dot JDBC JDBC dot driver. All right, this is the thing you have to write. Perfect. After that, you write PST equal con dot prepare statement. You write here is insert into just records. What are the records you have to? First one should be name. Second one should be what are the things you have created here. ST name course fee. So you have write the columns ST name course fee. What are the values you are going to pass it here? Values. This is a prepare statement. You have to put three question mark, right? This is the thing you have to write. Three question mark, right? Perfect. Now these values I am going to insert into these fields. These three questions mark, right? These fields are in the database column, right? So if you pass these values, this course here is passing to the name, second one passing to the course, third one passing to the fee, right? Now let's set them. PST dot set string. First one should be name. Second one should be control C to copy this one. Control C to copy. Control V to paste below. This one should be course. Third one should be fee. So right here is PST dot execute update. Right, that's the thing we have to write. Okay. After that, what I'm going to do is here. I'm going to this one we have to write it here is we have to get the message, right? So here what I'm going to see, you have to close it. Close the this one starting here. Close here. We have to write alert message. We have to pass the alert message. So, here we have to close the tag here in between this tag. We have to pass the alert message. This is passing from the JavaScript. So, that here we have to write here is script. Don't write the JavaScript code inside the JSP, it's not taken. Okay, after you have to end here. Don't close the bracket here, right? Within the inside the bracket, you have to write the JavaScript tag. Then only the alert box will be displayed. Okay, you have to write like this. Okay, this if is starting here, ended here, right? Now here we have to write the JavaScript code, right? So you have to write starting with script, script, right? Starting here script. Control C to copy, Control V to paste below. This one end. Script started and end. Inside here we have to write alert, alert. We have to write record added, record added, right? That's the thing you have to write, right? Now let's check whether it's working fine or not, right? John course Java fee 12,000 submit. That's the error here. Column course, right? Unknown column, column course, right? Column course, here. One R should be missing. That's the problem, right? Here goes, right? Now let's execute the program and check, right? John Coast Java fee 12,000. Click submit. Record added perfectly. Now let's check. Browse. It's added successfully. Here, John, right. All the stuff should be added successfully. John Java fee, right. Now what I'm going to do is record added perfectly. Now I'm going to view the records into the table, right. That's the thing I'm going to write. Okay, now let's back to our table. This is a table. This is a table headings, right? Now here we have to write after this tr close. Here we have to inside this tr our td is available. This td we have to show the our records, right? This table records we have to show inside this td, right? So how to connect the connection? So we have to write here. First, you have to write here is JDB tag. We have to write JSP tag. Open and close the tag. Right. Now here, what I am going to do is here, you have to just copy this one. That's the connection and everything. You have to copy this one. But you have to copy this one. Control C to copy. Control V to paste. Right. Connection object, repair statement, and everything you have to copy. Control C to copy and Control V to paste here. Right, that's the thing you have to do first stuff. Right, perfect. After that, what I'm going to do is here your database, your connection, all the stuff up perfectly. Now I'm going to write a code. For selection, we have select, so we have to write the SQL code. I mean, write to create the variable. This one should be, we have to write create the variable as here. Let's create as query variable. I'm going to create a query here. You write select all from which table you are going to select. Records is the table. It's the this school database reside the table records, right? So you have to create here. Records, right? Perfect, right? Records, right? After that, what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to write another class statement. Statement st equal con dot create statement. After that, you have to write rs equal. This also target rs equal st dot execute call. Here you have to write a pass this call. Control C copy, Control V to paste here. Right. That's the thing we have to write. After that, what I'm going to see, you have to write a while loop. It's going here, right? Perfect. While loop rs dot next. After that, we have to write here is first you have to write string id equal rs dot get string. You have to column first one should be id, pass it here. That's a thing we have to write first stuff you have to write here, right? Now we have to close it here, right? Now this one we have to tab key to get align, right? Press tab key on your keyboard and you have to align right like this, right? Perfect, right? Now here what I did is I select all from records pane, all the table records we have to load it and put into the variable query. Now here we have to execute it. After that, you have to set the variable. The first column, what is the ID available here? So we have to set it here and put into this variable, right? Now the all the ID should be stored in this variable, right? After that, we have to put it here, right? Now this while loop not ended here. We have to remove it the end step. So we have to end it here. At the end, right? At the TRN, right? You have to end here. perfect. If you end here, it is not work, the loop is not working, right? So here we have to write the inside here, we have to write the JSP tag, starting tag and closing tag. Here we have to, first step we have to write here is rs dot get string. You have to write here is, first one should be s name, right? That's the thing we have to write first, right? Now let's copy them. Ctrl C to copy, Ctrl V to paste here. You have to paste it here, right? Right here, the tag, closing tag. Right. Now here, what I'm going to do is here. This one should be course. This one should be fee. We have to display the fee. Right. That's the thing we have to write. The additional one should be, this one should be edit. This one should be delete. We'll get two stuff, edit and delete, right? That's the thing we have to do, right? We load the table and passing the data to this TDs, right? Now let's check, right? Now here additional spaces, we have to remove them. That is the store. Simple. Now let's execute the program and check. When they run the program, what happened? Column S name not found. What is the problem? S name AY not found. Let's go to the database. What's the things? ST name, sorry. This is ST name, right? Give the proper column name here. Okay, what is the column name you have written here? Same one you have to give here. Otherwise, it won't work, right? Now you can check now. Now it's working perfectly here. Student name, course, fee. Edit and delete button, right? I didn't make the link here, right? Perfect, it's working perfectly, right? Now here you are going to add another student, Peter, course JSP fee 50,000. Click record error, click OK. Here it's added perfectly, right? Now I'm going to give the link for these two things, right? I'm going to do the edit and delete part of the JSP. So let's back to our project. Now here I'm going to make the link for that edit. So first, if you do the edit part, what you are going to do is here, this is your project stud, this is your project stud. I'm going to create the another, select the web pages folder. I'm going to create another page JSP. This one should be update. Click finish. Right, it's a blank, right? Now we have to, this one we right. Now let's back to our index page. Now here what I'm going to do is here, edit here, we have to make the link. So first what I'm going to do is, we have to write the anchor tag, H-A-H-R-E-F. Here we have to write which page you are going to do. Click the edit button, go to the update.jsp page. So update.jsp, get the ID. This is the core string. You are using the core string to passing the ID to one page to another page. Equal, here we have to this ID you are passing here. How to get the ID in the, inside the core string is like this, equal ID. You have to write like this, simple, right? This ID is passing to the variable, this variable, this goes to that page, update page, along with the ID, right? The same thing we have to, Ctrl C to copy, Ctrl V to paste here. The same thing you have to write here, delete as well. Here we have to, this page we have to change it as delete.jsp. Delete page I'm going to create again, right click, new JSP delete. Right, finish. That's the stuff we have to do. Right, now let's go to the index page and check whether it's working fine or not. That another one important stuff we didn't do. That's the thing, anchor here to starting here, we have to close it here. We didn't put the closing tag of the anchor. Anchor tag right here also, we have to close the anchor tag here. this one close right this here. Here you have closed the enter tag here. Right, that's the thing we have to do. Right. Now let's execute the program and check. Now it's working perfectly. Now you can check here. Here, just move the cursor on this text, edit text. You will make the taskbar what happened here. Show the link. Here, update JSP ID is 1. Second, if you select second, ID will be 2. Right here, it's goes here. Right, perfectly. The same thing as a delete as well. Here, it goes to the page. In here, if you click on this one here, it goes update.jsp along with the ID 1. Right, it's perfectly. Right, it's working perfectly. Now I'm going to design the update.jsp page. If you click on this one, the relevant data should be passing to the update.jsp page. Now let's back to the update.jsp page. Here I'm going to write this one as update. Update data. Student update. Right. Now here I'm going to make the design. Now what I'm going to do is here the same thing. I'm going to copy and paste it. Go back to my index.jsp page. Here I need to copy only these things only. First we have to write class.row. So let's back to here. Div class. We have to write row. Inside the div, here only we need to paste it, this only, this tag only. You are starting from the call sm1, here outside this form, say complete form. You are starting the div here, starting, close it here, right? Inside the all the form contents, we have to copy, control C to copy, control V to paste here. This is the thing we have to do. Right, let's remove the stuff. That's the thing we have to do. Now what I'm going to do is here, let's check whether it's working fine or not, right? We already gave the link, so let's execute the program and check. Click edit button, it goes here, but the bootstrap is not there, the because I didn't add the bootstrap plugin. So let's back to our index.php page, sorry, JSP page. Here we have to this one, this link, this one, this bootstrap. Inside the attack, control C to copy, control V to paste inside the attack here. Control V to paste here. Now let's run the things and check. Click edit button. Now it's working fine, perfectly. Now, when you click edit button, along with the ID and data will be passing here. Relevant ID, what are the data you will be passing here, right? This data, if you click on this link, this all the data should be passing to this form, right? Now let's check, let's see how to do the task. So let's back here, get the ID and passing the data. So go to the update.jsp page. Here we have to write the code for that. Here, before we have writing the edit code, we have to first, when you select the record, the relevant record should be passing to the relevant text boxes. That is the stuff we have to do. Okay, so what I'm going to do is here, let's go here, right? Inside the form, first we have to get the record first. After that, we have to write the insert code here, right? Update code here, right? Now first I'm going to get the record into the passing to the relevant form. So first you have to write open the JSP tag and close the tag. So here you have to write right. Now here what I'm going to do is here first I'm going to write here is first I'm going to get the connection. So let's back to index.jsp page, the same connection we are copying. Connection of this all the stuff you have to copy, control C to copy, control V to paste here, it show the error. So what I'm going to do is here, go back to index, you have to copy this one, this package, SQL package, control C to copy, control, we need to paste here. We have to paste it here. Now the error go away, right? Because the all the SQL the SQL connection class all are available inside this package, so that if you are not written, it show the error, right? You have to do like this. Press tab key to align like this. It's an efficient way when you do the program, right? After that, what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to get the ID. So the ID is successfully displayed. When you click here, this ID should be successfully displayed. This ID, we have to get it and passing to the relevant one variable. So I'm going to write a variable string ID equal request dot get parameter. Here we have to write as a, this one should be the ID. That's it. After that, what I'm going to do is here, we have to write a prepare statement. Object prepare PST equal con dot prepare statement. Here we have to write SQL query select all from records where ID equal question mark. After that, what I'm going to do is you have to write a question prepare statement to set the ID. Right? What is the ID you are retrieving here? Right? You have to pass it to here, you have to set it to here, set string. So PST, so what is the error? Here you have to enter. You write PST dot set string. Here we have to write ID. That's the thing you have to do. Perfect. That's the thing only to. After that, we have to call the result set object RS equal PST dot execute query. Right. If you call this one, after that, you have to put the while loop and check. While RS dot next, you have to write here is like this. Right. Here, while loop is open. Right. Now here while loop is open after the end. Here after the end, we have to close the while loop. Here we have to close it. Starting here, close it here, right? Only these three dues we have to work on the while loop. Okay. Here we have to pass the student name, course, and fee. So here we have while loop we have to close, right? So we have to write the closing tag. We have to do. Right. After that, what I'm going to see, we have to pass the value into the here. So values here we have to pass JSP tag. We have to write a JSP tag here. We have to close tag. Here we have to write we have to write here is equal rs dot get string. Here we have to write here is name. You have to write as a st name. Right. Now the same thing you have to copy. You have to control C to copy. Control V to paste. This one should be course. You see anything, you have to copy the values. Control C to copy, Control V to paste here. This one should be fee. Right. That's the thing we have to do. Right. Now let's check. Right. This is the thing. Okay. Inside the text box, inside the values, we have to pass in the this value, these things. Right. What is when you select that click edit button, the relevant ID record should be passing here. Relevant ID is coming here. So the records table, what is the matching records? You select at and it is looping. You have to get the result here. Right. Now let's check whether it's working fine or not first. Click on the edit button.
here it's successfully passing, but the thing is the bootstrap the problem. So here I already added, but the problem like I remove it, we have to add the bootstrap flag. Index.php, just two things, control C, copy, control to paste here. Inside the tag we have to paste it. I have already written in the index.jsp page this bootstrap link. This way, same thing you have to copy and paste it inside the tag to on update.jsp. Let's check. Click on this one, it goes like this, perfectly. Now again we have to click this one, it goes perfectly, right? Now I need another one thing is we need one link here, this one. If you click the edit page back here, we have to create one link here. If you click this back button, it's go back to our page, so index page. So what I'm going to see here, we go after this div, after this div we have to create the link. So we have to create as div, simple div align right, you have to enter div. So we have to write here is this one should be we have to write we have to write a fun paragraph. Okay, we have to write click back. Right. Here we have to make the link. We have to write here is ahref. We have to write index.jsp. Here also we have to end it. Right, that's the thing we have to write. Now let's go to the index.jsp page. Click the edit button, goes here it's successfully coming the back. Click back, it goes here. If you click this one, click back, it goes here, right, perfectly. Now what I'm going to do is here, first I'm going to edit the data. After record is successfully visiting this page, now if you make the changes and click submit button, record is updated, right? So what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to go back to our update.jsp page here. I'm going to write the edit code. So this is very simple stuff. Let's back to our index.jsp page. You already written the code of insert code. The same code you have to copy. Your JSP code is tag is starting here, ended here. You have to copy it here along with the JavaScript, right? So here you have to copy it here. Control C to copy. Go back to your update.jsp page. Control V to paste here. Right? Same thing. You have to control C to copy and control V to paste here. Okay, so instead of if you are writing, it take too much of time to complete the project. It's very easy. Now here what I'm going to do is here, we need another one thing. Control C to copy this. I'm going to create another variable, string ID. This field request parameter ID. We create another field ID. Right? Get the ID and we have to update the record. Now here get the ID and update the record. So instead of insert query, we have to write the update query. So how to write update? What is the update? What is the table name? Records set st name. This st name equal question mark comma course equal question mark comma c equal question mark. Right. Where id equal question mark. That's the thing we have to do. This is the update call, right? Now here what I'm going to do is here, first one should be name. First name, I mean this one name, I have to pass it here. Second data course, third one fee, right? These things we have to update. How to update? Get the ID. So ID is here. So we need to control C to copy. You have to enter the, we have to reset string. This one should be 4, this one should be ID. Get the ID and update the record, right? Now this time record is not added, updated. Now let's check. Everything fine. ST name, all the fields are correct. Localhost. Table name is database name is school. This is the data, right? Now let's check. Click edit button, goes to here. John, I'm going to put another in. This one, I'm going to 20,000, make it as a 15,000. Click submit, record updated, click OK. Now let's back to the table. Here, it's perfectly updated. It's perfectly updated. Okay, if you click edit button here, it goes to the form, edit update form along with the ID, get the ID and it is update the record, right? It's get the ID and it's put into this variable here, it's passing here to update the record. Record updated perfectly. Now record is updated successfully. Now we need to do another one stuff is we need to delete the record, right? Okay, let's check how to delete the record. So let's back to our code. Very simple. I already written the delete.jsp page. Here we no need the design in this page. We have to remove it. We no need the design. Okay, keep it up, this one empty. Now we have to only write the delete code only. Okay, so let's back to our update.jsp page. The same thing we have to copy. Same thing you have to copy. Same thing you have to copy here. Control C to copy. The same thing you have to copy. And back to my, sorry, you have to copy this one. SQL also we needed. SQL, this one. Same update code you have to copy. Control C to copy. Back to my index.jsp page. Control V to paste here. Right, everything perfect. Now here we no need this one. If requires parameter submit, we no need it, right? So here we have, we get the link only. In this page, we only here, we have executed the program, only we have a link only. Okay, this update, delete link. If you click on this one, it goes to this page and get the ID and delete the entire row. So that's the only thing we have to need. The here, update why are you written here is requires parameter submit mean, I written the button here, submit button. Okay. If you click the submit button, if the user click submit button, it goes to the submit button, goes to this here, and if it is not null, and here it's to the validation part, right? Here no, there is no button, just a link, so it goes to the relevant page and delete the record. So we no need it. We have to remove the fields. We no need it. This one also we no need it. We have to remove that. Right, only we need only this one only. Okay, get the ID and remove the records. So ID only important, other data is we no needed. Get the name and course, all the stuff we no needed, only the ID, right? Get the ID and remove the record. So we no need this column, this one set free, right? Right, now here I'm going to write the query only for the this one only. Delete which table you are going to delete the records? Records the table. It's a table. Delete from which table? Records the table. So records where ID equal, what is the ID you are getting here when you click the record, when you click delete link, it's the ID is coming here. Get the ID and put here this one, this question, this one should be the ID here, this ID variable. You have to pass it here. The position should be 1, right? Because only one question marker there, right? 1. So here, record deleted. Right. Now let's check. Click delete button. Record deleted. Let's back. Refresh it. Record deleted. Perfect. It's perfect. Right? Here, if you click delete button. What happen is it goes to the ID and get the ID and delete the record. Now let's back here and refresh it. There is no record available. Now if you are going to add another record, Raja cost JST fee 20,000 and submit. Now record is set. Now it's working perfectly. I hope you understood the tutorial well. If you have any doubt on the JSP CRUD part, you can ask me anytime. If you like my channel, please subscribe me, like me. Thank you for watching.